Hello. I'm going to be doing an album by my favorite band again, Black Sabbath. So, the album I'm going to be doing this time is their fourth album. I'm not really going in any particular order for these Black Sabbath albums, so I'm just going to do whatever I feel like at the time. The album I'm going to be doing is called Black Sabbath Volume 4. And I have a lot for this album. The picture there is of Ozzy on stage, it's live, at some place during the, Master of Reality tour. I'm pretty sure they couldn't get a Volume 4 tour photo when this album was released, considering that I don't know how quickly they could get it in. I mean, maybe it is, but I don't know. And it's like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's done in one color, two color tone. And there's also a back of him. It's white with orange lettering, and the front has orange Ozzy and white lettering. I really like it, actually. I didn't like it before, but now I do. So the inside, though, features pictures of the band. So the first one features Geezer Butler, and then this one features Ozzy Osbourne, and then the middle page has the band at concert, as you can see. And then the next page features Bill Ward on this side, and then Tony Iommi, the guitarist, on that side. Now, if you haven't noticed, though, Bill Ward actually uses the other side of the drum. If you look closely, right there, that's not the side that the usual drummers use. So, the album was originally supposed to be called Snowblind in LA, but I guess they changed that for some reason. And there's a little note that they say on here. It says, "We'd like to wish the great Coca-Cola Company of Los Angeles." Obviously a reference to cocaine. So let's get started with the album. Oh, by the way, this was recorded in L.A., this album, I believe. Recorded at the record plant in Los Angeles. It was also the producer, Patrick Meehan, who didn't really help a lot, according to Tony Iommi's book. But I don't know. Who knows what they were thinking back then? They were all on cocaine. So, the first song that starts out is Wheels of Confusion. I guess it's a song about being confused about the world and what's going on. I don't really know. I think so. And then the next... I just realized, on the US versions, the second part to the songs, there's two parts. There's two songs on here that have a two-part title. Wheels of Confusion, and then The Straightener. On the US version, I guess, because this is an original copy, doesn't have The Straightener's title, but the song is still in there. And then on Under the Sun, the last track, it's got Every Day Comes and Goes, which isn't said on here, obviously. Kind of weird, I just noticed that right now. So, let's start with the album, shall we? First song, Wheels of Confusion, it's kind of being like confused and everything. It's kind of trippy, really, and it's kind of heavy, too. This album is, it's really heavy. I've never noticed how heavy it is until now. Well, actually, I did notice. And it's a really good track. I really like it. The next track is called Tomorrow's Dream. It's about, saying to a girl, "I'm gonna leave you, and that's just my wish. It's tomorrow's dream. I don't know what tomorrow's gonna be. I kinda like it. I want it to be like that." It's saying, I wanna live my life. I don't know. I'm really bad at this. At interpreting songs. I can just tell you if I like them or not. The next song is called Changes. It's got piano and vocals. and some strings, I guess. I don't know. I'm not really a fan of it. At all. I'm not really a fan of it at all. The next track is FX. It's like a reverb kind of thing. Everybody's like using their instruments and reverbing everything through the amps, I guess. It's okay. It's good for effects. Supernaut. Now that is a headbanger. And I used to headbang so much to this song, and I headbanged so hard, and it was just like, it was really fast, and it's all over the place. It's really a great riff. It used to be my favorite riff, until Sabbath Bloody Sabbath came along, when I heard it. Then you flip over to side two. The next song is Snowblind, which is about cocaine. Obviously, being snowblind, being under the influence of cocaine. It's really a great song. One of my favorites off the album. The next song is called Cornucopia. I guess it's about having your own little world of perfectness, and nobody ever really bothers you. Originally, I thought it was like keeping mentally insane people in, because it was like, let them have their little games. Stuff like saying, like, leave them alone, they got their own little world. I don't know. The next song is called Saint Vitus Dance. It's about a guy telling a friend that his girlfriend didn't really want to cheat on him at all. She just left because you didn't love her. You were always suspicious of her. It's really a great song. Oh shoot. I also forgot Laguna Sunrise. Laguna Sunrise is an instrumental. It's really soft and just easy and just, it's good. The next song. Hold on. The riff kicks in. It's heavy. Shit, wrong song. Yeah, here we go. Got to be the heaviest riff that Tony Iommi has ever created. It's so goddamn heavy. And it starts out really just like out of nowhere. It's just like so goddamn heavy. I love it. It's probably my second favorite song by Black Sabbath. And it's got the second part that's the straightener. That's a little quicker of a song part. But the song is about like, back then, people were telling Black Sabbath that they're Satanists and everything, and like people were just getting all religious over this. This is a song kind of telling them, "Hey, we're not Satanists. Just leave me alone. I want to live my life. Don't talk to me about that stuff. All right? I don't want to hear about it. So go away. Really." God. So that's my review of the album Volume 4. I really like the album. It's really a great album. It's probably one of my, third favorite, maybe? I don't know, I can't really choose. Also, my opinions on the, new, Black Sabbath album, 13. Yeah, I love it. I can't get over that album. I've listened to it a couple of times, and it's just, like, maybe it's because it's just fresh and I haven't really, but so far, I love it. I can't get my mind off it. It's like the greatest album they have made in the past 35 years. It's just so great. I love it, and I can't wait to own it. And maybe I'll review it fully one day. That's my review. Black Sabbath fan here. Also, I'm gonna plug in a friend of mine. His name is I think he's in my link channels, but his name is Rock and Roller 95, 795. I don't know. He's in my so if you wanna go see him, check out my channel and go to my channel links, and you'll see one of his channel. He's got the picture Paranoid on it. He's really a good guy, kid, because he's also, plays guitar, and he really does really great covers of Black Sabbath. I mean, seriously, like, this guy's amazing, honestly. So, yeah.